Hello everyone, I hope you are doing good. In this video, you will learn about maps and their different types. So let us start our today's class. We all know maps are of utmost importance if we want to travel from one place to another. They help us to figure out where we are and how to get where we want to go. For example, if we want to travel from one country to another or from one place to another inside a country, then we use a map. There are a variety of maps available to us, showing different political and physical features of states, countries, and the world. You must have seen a world map. It gives us information about all the continents and oceans, but not in their accurate shapes and sizes. I know it would be surprising to hear, but this is true, that the world map does not represent the exact size and shape of the continents and oceans. Can you think of the reason behind it? It is because our Earth is spherical in shape, and when it is drawn on a flat surface, the drawing gets distorted. To understand it better, you can take an old rubber ball and draw whatever you like all over it. You may also mark the North Pole and the South Pole on it. Now cut the ball with a knife and try to flatten it. You can notice how the drawings are distorted. Similarly, a flat map cannot accurately show the curved surface of the Earth. When a map is drawn, the shapes and sizes of the continents and oceans get distorted. The maximum distortion occurs in the regions around the poles, while the equatorial region can be shown with reasonably less distortion. Hence, it is suggested to use a globe. Globe is a true model of the Earth. It is useful when we want to study the Earth as a whole. But when we want to study only a part of the Earth, as about our country, state, district, towns, and villages, it is of little help. For that purpose, we use maps. A map can be defined as a representation or a drawing of the Earth's surface or a part of it, drawn on a flat surface according to a scale. A map is different from a globe in many ways. First, globe is bulky and cannot be carried easily, whereas map is easy to handle and can be carried everywhere. The second difference is, a globe cannot show the details of landforms, the location of small towns and villages, whereas a map gives us detailed information about a place. So we can say, maps are useful to us for various purposes. One map shows a small area and a few facts. Another map may contain as many facts as a big book. A book that contains a variety of maps is known as an atlas. Or you can say, when many maps are put together, we get an atlas. I hope this much is clear to you. Now let us go to the next topic, types of maps. Maps are of various types, providing different kinds of information. On the basis of the information provided, we have classified them into three different types. The first one is physical maps. The second one is political maps. And the third one is thematic maps. Let us know about each type of map in detail. Political maps. Political maps show the boundaries of administrative units, such as countries, states, and districts. Different types of boundaries are shown with different symbols. They also show the location of cities, towns, and villages. The next one is physical maps. They show the landforms and water bodies on the earth's surface, such as mountains, plateaus, plains, rivers, lakes, and seas. The different features are shown in different colors. Now come to the last one, that is thematic maps. They show the distribution of forest, crops, minerals, industries, etc. The title of the thematic maps is given on the basis of the information provided in these maps. For example, a climatic map shows the climatic conditions of an area. Similarly, a rainfall map shows the distribution of rainfall of an area. I hope this is clear to you. Now you can easily identify the different types of maps available to us. So let us end today's class here. In the next video, we will continue with components of maps. Do subscribe my channel and get notifications about upcoming videos. Thank you everyone. Hello everyone, in this video you will study about important components of a map. Every map has certain components that act as tools and help us to read and interpret it. These are called essential components of a map. They are distance, directions, and symbols. Let us know about each component in detail. You have learnt in the previous video that maps are drawings which reduce the entire world or a part of it to fit on a sheet of paper. But this reduction is done very carefully so that the distance between the two places on the map corresponds to the same two places on the ground. For this purpose, we select scale of the map. Do you know what is this scale of a map? A scale of a map is the ratio between the actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. To understand it better, let us look at the map shown here. Suppose this is a place A and this is another place B, and the distance between these two places is 6 cm on the map. Now you have to find out the distance between the same two places on the ground. Can you do it? Yes, you can easily find it out if you know the scale of this map. Suppose the scale of the map is 1 centimeter equal to 200 kilometers, which means 1 centimeter on the map represents 200 kilometers on the ground. Therefore, 6 centimeter on the map will represent 6 into 200 equal to 1200 kilometers on the ground. Here, I have simply multiplied the map distance, which is 6 cm, to 200, that is the scale of the map. It is very simple and easy to calculate. By now, you must have understood that scale is very important in any map. If you know the scale, you will be able to convert the distance between any two places on a map into the actual distance on the ground. I hope this is clear to you. If you remember, in my last video you studied about three different types of maps: political, physical and thematic. Now we are going to classify maps on the basis of scale. First one is small scale map and second one is large scale map. Let us know about each type of map in detail.
A small scale map refers to world maps or maps of large regions such as continents, large oceans, etc. In other words, you can say they show large areas of land in a small space and use a small scale such as 1 centimeter equal to 1000 kilometer, which means 1 centimeter on the map shows 1000 kilometer on the ground. Here I would like you to remember one thing, is that a small scale map gives very little information. Do you know why? Because a large area is reduced to a very small size, then represented on a flat surface, due to which it is not possible to provide detailed information on a small scale map. I hope you got my point. Now come to the large scale map. The large scale map refers to neighborhood maps, district or town maps. In other words, you can say when a small area is to be shown on paper, then we use a large scale. For example, 6 centimeter equal to 600 meters. That means 6 centimeter on the map shows 600 meters on the ground. As it is a small area, we can get more information on the map. Hence, you can conclude that a large scale map gives us more information than a small scale map. I hope the difference between small scale map and large scale map is clear to you. So children, let us end today's class here. In the next video, we will continue with directions. Do subscribe my channel and get notifications about upcoming videos. Thank you everyone.
Hello everyone. Hope you are doing good and enjoying learning through my videos. So let us start our today's class. In today's video, you will learn about one of the essential components of a map, that is direction. It is very important to know in which direction you have to go if you want to reach the exact location. Am I right? There are many ways to find directions. First, facing the rising sun. Second, with the help of the pole star. Third, by using a magnetic compass. I'm sure you must have seen a magnetic compass. It is an instrument used to find out the main directions. Its magnetic needle always points towards the north-south direction, so we can easily find out the direction on the ground. But how can we find them on a map? If you look at the map carefully, you will notice an arrow marked with the letter N at the upper right-hand corner. This arrow shows the north direction. When you know the north, you can easily find out the other three directions, that are east, west and south. Do remember, if the north is not shown on a map, the top of the map is taken as the north and the bottom as the south. When you stand facing the map, the right hand side is the east and the left hand side is the west. These four directions, east, west, north and south, are called
cardinal points. Apart from cardinal directions, there are other four intermediate directions. They are northeast, southeast, northwest, and southwest. These intermediate directions are very helpful in locating any place more accurately. I hope this is clear to you. Let us try to locate some places with the help of these intermediate directions. Can you tell me on which side of the temple is the school located? Yes, your answer is correct. It is southwest. Now look at this figure and find out on which direction Raja will have to go to reach his school. Yes, you are absolutely right. He will have to go to northwest. So children, that's all you had to study under this topic. Hope you found it easy and interesting. So let us end today's class here. In the next video, we will continue with symbols. Thank you everyone. Hello everyone, hope you are doing good and enjoying learning through my videos. So let us start our today's class on the topic symbols. Here I am talking about the symbols that are used on a map. They help us to understand the information given on it. They are small pictures that are often drawn to look like what they represent. For example, a triangular shape is often used to denote a mountain. A desert is shown by a group of dots that might look a little bit like sand, and so on. As you know, maps are used for recording and showing a variety of information, such as political boundaries, relief features, social and cultural features like temple, buildings, railway lines, etc. But it is not possible to draw the actual shape and size of these features on a map. So they are shown by using certain letters, shades, colors, pictures, and lines. These signs and symbols give us a lot of information in a limited space. With the use of these symbols, map can be drawn easily and are simple to read. Let us try to draw some of the conventional symbols. But before that, I would like you to know, why are they called conventional symbols? They are called because there is an agreement among many countries of the world about the common use of these signs and symbols. For example, blue is always used to show water bodies, and green is used for the plains, which you can see over here on the map. Thus, these signs and symbols are called conventional signs and symbols. Let us have a look at some of the conventional signs and symbols which are very common in use. This sign stands for temples. This one is used for settlements. To show metallic roads, we use this sign. And this is for trees. Some of you might find it difficult to learn and may think about how to memorize them. But you don't need to worry, because on the map, you can find the key of the map or map legend. What is this map legend? The map legend is a table of symbols printed on a map to give a better understanding or interpretation of it. With the help of this table, you can easily find out about a particular symbol
and what it represents. For better understanding, let us have a look at this map legend, in which you can see signs and symbols for national highways, roads, river, lake, government office, school, college, mosque, church, and temple. Now you can easily find out the location of these places on the map. Let us take the example of a church and find out where it is located in the given area. You know very well, this sign stands for the church. Here you can find the same sign. So you can say, this is one of the locations where you can find a church. Clear? So children, these are some of the internationally accepted signs and symbols which are used on a map. Even if we don't know the language of an area and therefore cannot ask someone for directions, you can collect information from maps with the help of these symbols, because maps have a universal language that can be understood by all. Now it's your turn to look at some of the maps given in your book and try to figure out the important features shown on them. Hope it would be fun for you. With that, we end today's class here. In the next video, you will learn the difference between map, sketch, and plan. Do subscribe my channel and get notifications about upcoming videos. Thank you everyone. Hello everyone. So are you ready to find out the difference between map, sketch, and plan? As you know very well, that the information shown on a map can only be read and understood if you know its language, which includes scale, direction, and symbols. But what if we don't use a scale, direction, and symbols on a drawing? Will it be called a map? No. Such kind of drawing is known as a sketch. In other words, you can say a sketch is a rough drawing. To understand it better, let us assume that one of your friends wants to come to your house for the first time and doesn't know the location of your house. Then in that case, you would draw a rough diagram of roads to show where to turn and which landmark to look out for in order to reach your home. With this rough diagram, your friend can easily reach to your house, even though the exact distance and direction are not mentioned. Such a diagram is called a sketch. Thus, you can define a sketch as a drawing mainly based on memory and spot observation. It is drawn without a scale and without any conventional symbols. Directions and distance are not correctly represented, and detailed features are not shown on a sketch. I hope this is clear to you. So now you know that sketch is a simple drawing, whereas a map shows either a large area with little details or a small area in detail. Although a map shows the detailed features of an area, it cannot show too many accurate details of a very small area, like a house, an office building, or a classroom. Therefore, when many details of a small area are to be shown, we have to draw a plan. A plan is a drawing of a small area on a large scale. And you know very well,
A large scale map gives us a lot of information. Thus, you can say, plan is a detailed drawing of a very small area drawn on a very large scale. For example, the layout of your house, school, etc. I hope the difference between the map, sketch, and plan is clear to you. So children, that's all you had to study under this chapter. Let us end today's class here. In the next video, we will continue with a new chapter. Do subscribe my channel and get notifications about upcoming videos. Thank you everyone.